Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. Myself Tejashree Tukaram Shirsagar, and for this year in the academic year 2021-22, I am going to teach you one of the most interesting subject, that is nothing but what? Science. Okay, so I am dealing with the science. I am going to teach you about the science. So if we'll talk about the science, so as you know, the science we can see everywhere in our surrounding. There are so many things are there. There are so many things working. Okay, and behind that each and everything there is one reason. And that if we'll try to find out the answer of that reason, then that nothing but what we are discussing about the science. Okay, so without wasting our time, let's move for our syllabus. So in this science today, I am going to start the first lesson from your textbook. Okay, and the name of that lesson is what? Food and digestion. Okay, it means what we are going to discuss in this lesson. We are going to discuss about the food. What happened to the food? It will take it inside. Where it goes? Where it get disappear? How we are feeling energetic if we are having the food? All these are question answer we are going to find out in these upcoming lectures. Okay, so again I will repeat, what is the name of our lesson? The name of our lesson is what? Food and digestion. Okay, so let's start to discuss about the things which are related to our subject or which are related to our lesson. So I will ask you the one question. Okay, so there are the some time. Okay, after the interval of the time we are feeling hungry. Okay, we can say in the morning time we are feeling hungry, in the afternoon time we are feeling hungry, sometimes during the evening also we are feeling hungry. Mother, mama, I am feeling hungry, give me something to eat. Like that you are telling to your parents. Why is it so? Why you are feeling the hungry? Yes, we are feeling the hungry because our body requires the food. Okay, our body requires the food. But the again question is that why our body requires the food? Our body requires the food because our body performs the different work. Okay, our body performs the different work. Now, which are the works like that? We can say whenever you are doing any walking, or whenever you are walking, running, jumping, even when you are doing the study. Okay, even when you are doing the study, whenever you are doing the reading also, that time also our body requires the food. Okay, why our body requires the food? To perform all these activities. Okay, to perform all these different functions, our body requires energy, and that energy we are getting from food. Okay, so to perform the different work, to perform the different tasks, to perform the daily activity, our body requires energy, and that energy we are getting from the food. Okay, so food gives us energy to perform the different activity. Also food helps us to grow and keep our body healthy. Okay, so remember, whenever you are not having the food on the time, then we are feeling, okay, then what happens? Then once we have the food, enough meal, once we have the enough food atom, then we are feeling very easy, then we are feeling very energetic. Okay, our body get enough energy from that food, and then again we started to do our work. Okay, so in this way what we can say, that the energy we are getting from the food, that energy we can use to perform the different activities. Also this same energy is get utilized, it get used by our body to grow and also to keep our body healthy. Okay, so this is about what? Food. So in that food there are the different nutrients. Okay, the whatever the food items we are having in our daily life, for example we can say in the breakfast we are having the different food material, we are having the different food stuff, like that we are having poha, upma, sometimes we are having idli, dosa, etc, etc. Okay, so all these are the food items. From each and every food item we get, our body gets some different nutrients. Okay, our body gets different nutrients. Also in the meal, like that in the lunch and in the dinner we are having roti, chapati, bhakri. Also we are having rice, pulses, different vegetables. So from each and every food material we are getting the nutrients. Okay, but see, again and again I am telling one word, that is what? Nutrient. So what is in my nutrient? So let's discuss the definition of the nutrients. Nutrients, the substances that are needed by our body. For what purpose? present in the different food material. Okay, these are the substances which are present in the different food material, and they are necessary for our body. They are needed to our body for what purpose? For to keep our good health and growth. For the proper health and the proper growth of our body, the nutrients are important. Again, I will repeat, the substances that are needed by our body for good health and growth are called nutrients. Okay? So, mainly there are the five major nutrients that are carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamins and minerals. Along with these nutrients, our body also requires the enough amount of the water and the roughage. What is mean by water? What is mean by the roughage? Why it is necessary that, and why all that nutrients are necessary to our body? That all we are going to see deeply one by one. So today we will start with the first nutrient, that is nothing but what? Carbohydrates. Okay, what? Carbohydrates. So the carbohydrates is the one type of the nutrients, and there are the two types of the carbohydrate. One is sugar. Another one is starch. Okay, so there are so many different food materials are there, those contains the carbohydrate. But there are some food materials which contains the carbohydrate, some types of the carbohydrate, or some foodstuffs contain the sugar, while the some foods contains the starch. For example, as we know, sugar cane. What is the taste of the sugar cane? Comment me in the comment box. Okay, or give me answer in the comment box. Okay, so if I ask this question, what is the taste of the sugar cane? Then obviously it is what? Sweet. Why? Because that sugar cane contains the carbohydrate. But which type of the carbohydrate it contains? That is nothing but what? Sugar. Okay, next one. As you know, potato is there, and most of the students or most of the small kids, potato is most favorite vegetable. So that potato also one type of the carbohydrate. But is it a sweet in the taste? No, potato is not sweet in a taste. But still it is carbohydrate. It means what? What it contains? Which type of the carbohydrate it contains? It contains the starch. Okay. So different food materials are there. That food materials contain the carbohydrate. But among that food materials, some materials, foodstuffs contains the sugar, while some foodstuff contains the starch. Okay, so in this way we can say that the carbohydrate contain two types. There are the two types of the carbohydrate, sugar and starch. Okay, and this carbohydrate gives us more energy to our body. Okay, and that is the reason these carbohydrates are called as what? Energy giving food, because the carbohydrate helps to get our body enough energy, and that is the reason the carbohydrates are called as what? Energy giving food. Next one, the person those who are doing very high or there are very physical activities. Okay, also the person those who are athletes means what? Runner, boxer. Okay, in this way we can say that. So the person those who are doing heavy physical activity, athletes, rickshaw pullers are there. Okay, some masons are there, those who are working on the building construction. All those are the people, those who are doing very hard work. Okay, physical work they are doing most. Then that type of the person requires the food which is rich in the carbohydrate. Why? Because the carbohydrate is an energy giving food. That person requires the more amount of the energy. And if they will have the more amount of the carbohydrate, then obviously they will get the more amount of the energy to perform their work. Okay. Now we will discuss about which are the sources of the carbohydrate, from where we are getting the carbohydrate. So we are getting the carbohydrate from the different food stuff, like that we are getting the carbohydrate from the honey, rice, wheat, maize, jowar, bajra, bread, all banana, all these are the food material which gives us what? Carbohydrate. Okay, so this is about carbohydrate, that is the first nutrient. Now we will move for the second one. Now the second one nutrient we are going to discuss about what? Protein. This is also very important. This protein nutrient help us to grow. Okay, help us to grow. Also this protein, the growing children like you, now still your growth is not completed. Up till the age of the 18, our growth is going on. Remember yourself when you was in the second standard, that time your height was short. But now you have entered in the fourth standard, and now your height is more than the height of the first standard. Okay, it means what? Still you are growing, still your body growth is not completed. So you are what? Growing children. So these growing children requires the more amount of the protein. Why? Because protein help us to grow. Next one is there. Also, this protein help us to build the muscles and repair our damaged tissue or to repair our body. Sometimes any cuts or any wounds get appears or you are having any cuts or wounds. Okay, then as the time passes, after the certain interval of the time, it get healed by its own. Okay, we are applying some antiseptic creams and all, but still after the some time it get healed out. Why is it so? Because of the presence of the protein. Okay, so protein help us to build muscle and repair our body, and that is the reason the food which is rich in the protein, that food are called as body building food. Which food? Body building food. Okay, so the food which is rich in the protein are called as body building food. Now we will discuss about the sources of the protein. From which food material we are getting the protein? We can get the protein from the chicken, meat, fish, egg. Okay, so all cheese also there. All these are the food materials which are rich in the proteins. And the pulses are also there, which are rich in the protein, which help us to grow our body, maintain it, to do the maintenance of our body. Okay, now the next one we are going to see, the next nutrient, that is nothing but what? Fats. So the fat is the richest source of energy. It gives us more and more amount of the energy. If we do the comparison of the carbohydrate and the fats, then carbohydrates also gives the energy, fats also gives us the energy, but the amount of the energy given by the fats is more than the amount of the energy given by the carbohydrates. Okay, or in the easy words I can say that what? The fats gives us more amount of the energy than carbohydrates. So here fat is the richest source of energy. Next one, and that is the reason the fats are called as what? Energy giving food. Okay, but it gives us the more amount of the energy, but still also our body requires the fats in very less amount. Okay, because the excessive fat, if you take the more amount of the fatty food, the food which gives us more amount of the fat, then what will happen? The fat started to get collected in our body and it causes the obesity, or it makes the person obese. Obese means what? See in the picture, how is that man? How much it is fat? Okay, that is only called as what? Obesity, or it makes the people obese. Okay, and also it causes many different diseases. Okay, so the excessive fat is not good for our body. Since the fat gives us more amount of the energy, but still we have to take the less fat giving food. Okay, in this way, this is about what? Fats. So from which things we are getting the fats? Fats basically we are getting from the different nuts, also oil, ghee, butter, milk. All these are the things that gives us fats. Okay, so these are the sources of the fats. So my dear students, up till now we have discussed about the three nutrients, that are carbohydrate, proteins and fats. Okay, so this is all about today. Today your homework is that the same point you have to do the reading. You have to do the reading of the same point. Okay, from your science textbook. Okay, so we will stop here. We will meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.